It's Friday, May 1st, 2015. Hello, I'm Veronique Masterson. Here's what you need to know about what's happening at the University of Texas at El Paso. UTEP researchers may have discovered a simpler way to grow stem cells. Biomedical engineer Binata Jodar, who runs UTEP's Inspired Materials and Stem Cell-Based Tissue Engineering Lab, says the discovery suggests that feeder cells may not be important for stem cell growth. The discovery, described in the Journal of Materials Chemistry B, challenges the theory that feeder cells provide nutrients to growing stem cells after a new study successfully grew stem cells with dead or fixed feeder cells. The discovery offers a simpler, more cost-effective way to grow stem cells, including storing them at room temperature and spending less time cultivating them. An interdisciplinary effort is getting closer to silencing pertussis, also known as whooping cough. Chemistry Assistant Professor Dr. James Lee and Clinical Lab Science Professor Dr. Delfina Dominguez will receive more than $400,000 from the National Institute of Allergy and Infectious Diseases to continue their development of a low-cost, paper-based biochip to detect the contagious respiratory infection. The procedure involves placing a sample from a nasal swab into a device similar to a pregnancy strip that will change color to indicate the presence of the bacteria. The handheld device could be used in schools, doctors' offices, and other areas that have limited access to medical supplies, equipment, and medications. Current diagnostic methods require costly, specialized equipment and machines. Undergraduate electrical engineering student Efrain Aguilera is creating a 3D-printed unmanned aerial vehicle, or UAV. According to Professor Eric McDonald, who helps run UTEP's WM Keck Center for 3D Innovation, the UAV is unique because it incorporates 3D-printed electronics. Researchers around the world have struggled to create 3D-printed electronics in the last decade, but UTEP has become an expert in the process. Aguilera expects to test fly the UAV prior to his graduation in May. May is Older Americans Month, and this year's theme is Getting Into the Act. The two main programs UTEP offers to seniors who want to exercise their minds and bodies are the Osher Lifelong Learning Institute, or OLLIE, and Physical Fitness in the Golden Age. Together, they draw about 650 El Paso area residents, age 50 and older, per semester. Registered members of UTEP's Physical Fitness in the Golden Age will compete in the first Golden Age Games from 8 a.m. to 10 a.m. Saturday, May 2nd at Kidd Field. The games are free and open to the public. During the spring semester, the university also hosts an annual estate planning conference for women where business professionals offer advice about asset protection, elder law, charitable giving, life insurance, and aspects of estate planning. For more information about these and other stories, check out utepnews.com. I'm Veronique Masterson. We'll see you next Friday. Go Miners!